Good morning, boys and girls. Today we're going to learn about the Holy Spirit and how the Holy Spirit fell upon the apostles after Jesus' ascension to heaven. Now, I have always loved the story about the Holy Spirit coming at Pentecost. It's a story of the birth of the church. Now, Jesus started his work of the gospel when he was on earth. And because the disciples waited for the Holy Spirit to come on them, like Jesus told them to do, their ministry just totally changed after that. And so did a lot of people's lives. Jesus sent his Spirit to be with the disciples so that they could continue Jesus' work and take the gospel to the whole world. Now, even though the book of Acts is called the Acts of the Apostles, it's really a record of what Jesus did through the apostles to provide salvation for the whole world.
Good morning, kids. Well, before we get into the lesson, let's take some time to pray. Eden Armenta has asked us to pray for the safety of her family during this time. So, let's pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, we just ask that you would be watching over and protecting all the kids and their families in the church, Lord. That you would give the kids strength and wisdom and protect them during this time. Give the parents, their parents, strength and wisdom to help the kids through this. Take away fear and anxiety and replace it with your peace. And Lord, we lift up Eden Armenta and her family and pray that you would just be blessing them and protecting them during this time. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. In today's lesson, we're going to learn about when Jesus sent his disciples the Holy Spirit and how they then passed the Holy Spirit on to others, and how the Holy Spirit was part of God's plan to reach the entire world. Our lesson comes from the book of Acts, chapter 1, verses 1 through 14, and Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 through 47. Jesus had spent 3 years with his disciples, teaching them about his kingdom. After he rose from the dead, Jesus spent more time helping the disciples understand his plans. But Jesus' friends still thought that Jesus was going to run the Romans out of Israel and restore Israel as an independent nation. So the disciples asked Jesus, "Now are you going to be ruler over Israel?" Jesus answered the disciples by telling them two important things. First, he told them, "The Father sets those dates, and they are not for you to know." And then Jesus told them something important that they did need to know. "When the Holy Spirit has come upon you, you will receive great power to testify about me with great effect to the people in Jerusalem, throughout Judea, in Samaria, and to the ends of the earth about my death and resurrection." As soon as he finished speaking, Jesus rose into the air and disappeared into the clouds. Wow, what would you have thought if he had seen that? That's pretty amazing. The disciples stood staring up, amazed. Jesus had just left them. Now, how would God's kingdom ever become reality? So Jesus' friends went back to Jerusalem. They stayed together praying and talking. They did not know when or how the Holy Spirit would come, but they waited and hoped. What are some things that you have had to wait for? Your birthday, opening presents, waiting for this quarantine to be over and we can see our friends in person again? That's something I'm waiting for. Several weeks later, the disciples were together praying and still waiting as Jesus had asked. Suddenly, there was a sound like a roaring of a mighty windstorm, and it filled the house where they were meeting. What looked like flames or tongues of fire appeared and settled on their heads, and everyone present was filled with the Holy Spirit. Then something else unusual happened. The disciples began to talk about Jesus and praise God in other languages, languages they had never learned. Lots of people from many nations were in Jerusalem to celebrate Pentecost. For the Jews, Pentecost was a feast that was celebrated 50 days after Passover. Remember, Jesus celebrated Passover with his disciples just before he was crucified. So when people heard God's praises in all their different languages, they crowded around to see what was going on. The people were all hearing of God's wonderful works in their very own language. "How is this happening?" they wondered. "What does this mean?" But some of the people in the crowd laughed and said, "These people are drunk." But Peter spoke up, "Fellow Jews and everybody here, let me explain. These men are not drunk. God's Holy Spirit has come." Then Peter told the people about Jesus. He told them how wrong they had been to crucify Jesus, God's Son. He said Jesus was the one who had sent the Holy Spirit to them. Many of the people in the crowd finally realized that Jesus was God's Son. They felt sorry for the wrong things they had done. "What shall we do?" they asked. Peter knew the answer. "Repent." Repent means to turn from your sin, to stop doing wrong and to start doing what's right. Repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus, the Messiah. Jesus promises to forgive your sins and to send you his Holy Spirit. This is his promise to everyone. So what do you think happened next? Well, 3,000 people decided to follow Jesus that very day. These men and women had a new faith in Jesus, and their faith was off to a big, amazing start. But they didn't just say that they believed in Jesus. They listened carefully to everything Peter and the other disciples taught about Jesus, and they showed their faith in their attitudes and actions. They worshiped together at the temple every day, met in small groups and homes for communion, sharing their meals and praising God. They were growing and becoming the people that Jesus wanted them to be. So kids, I want to encourage you not only to say that you believe in Jesus, but to show your faith in him through your actions. Have a wonderful week. Be safe. Bye.
Hi guys. Hi Charlie. Hi Malia. What are you guys looking at up there?
Well, Chris, the Bible verse says, "Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith." Hebrews 12:2.
Oh, I see. So you guys are looking... Well, I got a better idea to help you keep your eyes fixed on Jesus. Why don't you try praying or reading your Bible? That will help your heart stay close to Him and keep your eyes fixed on Him.
Oh, I like to read my Bible.
And I like to pray.
Well, there you go. That will really help keep your eyes fixed on Jesus. Why don't you guys do the same this week? Let us fix our eyes on Jesus,
the author and perfecter of our faith.
Hebrews 12:2.
Okay, so that's the plan. Read your Bible this week and pray.
Bye.
Bye.
Well, boys and girls, today we're going to learn how to braid. Our Bible verse is, "Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith." So the Bible verse is Hebrews 12, verse 2. And I've put that on my little happy face with his eyes looking up. And these are what our bookmarks are going to look like when we're done. And you can use ribbon or you can use pipe cleaner. And hopefully you've got different colored pipe cleaners. You're going to need a hanger, which I don't think I said in the directions, but you'll need a hanger. And you're going to need, which I don't think I said, a little piece of stiff paper or cardboard. You can even use the backside of a pad of paper if you want to make it a little more stiff. But anything to make a happy face with the eyes looking up. And when I'm all done, and you can see I even colored the backside because I like stripes and grids. And then I'm going to put them on my paper clip. Like this. And he's ready. So now I'm going to show you guys how to braid. All right, so I had to move to a doorknob, and that's what you boys and girls are going to need. And I have my wire hanger. You'll have to bend it a little bit. I have two large paper clips because I'm going to do two of the bookmarks. I'm going to do one with the pipe cleaners and one with my ribbon. So I'm going to do the pipe cleaners first. I'm going to set my ribbon down here and my paper clips for now. And I'm going to take my wire coat hanger, and what I've done is I've squished this because I'm going to hang this on the doorknob. You're gonna either need this or someone to hold your paperclip, but we're gonna do it all on our own. So I'm gonna take this, and since I've squished it, it should kind of clip over my doorknob like that. And then I'm gonna take my first paperclip and I'm gonna clip it on this side because I need it to hold. So I'm going to go ahead and clip this in there. All right, so I'm going to show you boys and girls how to braid with the three different colors of pipe cleaner first. So I'm going to get them to match up, and then I'm going to stick all three of these ends into my paper clip here. I'm going to stick them in. And I'm going to pull it through so that it's halfway through. And then I'm going to go ahead and bend it down. All right, make it halfway through. Oop, it's a good thing about pipe cleaners, you can change your mind. Good, all right. Next, I'm going to start to braid. So we're going to braid, and you're going to separate your two strands of red
and your two strands of yellow. Well, I'm using red, yellow, and purple. I don't know what color you boys and girls are using, but hopefully you can tell the difference between your strands, all right? And then I have my purple. I'm holding it with my right hand, thumb, and fingers. I'm holding my red one with my left hand, thumb, and fingers. Now my middle one has to be held as well. So the middle finger of each one of your hands is going to be the holder. So in a moment, my middle finger is going to hold. But right now I have my thumb and first finger holding my red. That's the one, the strand that's on the far left. And my middle finger is holding the middle strand. Now I'm going to cross over. So I'm going to twist like this. And now my red is in the middle. Well, I have to cross over now my right purple one. So I'm going to take my middle finger. I'm going to grab the middle one, my red one, and I'm going to grab it, and then I'm going to cross over. Now my middle one is in the middle. Well, over here, I haven't changed my fingers yet, because now I need to change my fingers so that they're holding tight my thumb and two fingers, and my middle finger is going to get ready to grab the middle strand. Now I've changed fingers over here so that I'm pulling my red one and holding it with my thumb and fingers. I'm ready to twist my yellow and purple. So I twist it, and now the yellow is in the middle. With my right hand and my middle finger, I'm going to grab the yellow, and then I'm going to change my fingers over here so that they're holding tight to the purple, and I'm going to twist over. Now my red one is in the middle. I'm going to use my middle finger on the left, and I'm going to grab the red, change my fingers on the right so they're holding tight, and then I'm going to twist. Now I need my right middle finger, and I'm going to grab, and I'm going to twist. Now I need my left middle finger, and I'm going to grab the yellow one, and I'm going to twist. I take my right middle finger, and I'm going to grab it, change my fingers on my left, and I'm going to twist. And then I'm going to grab it, change my fingers here so I'm holding tight, and twist. And I'm going to grab it, change my fingers over here, and then I'm going to twist. So for you boys and girls that are using ribbon, I've got three strands of ribbon, and I've cut them all about the same length. I've got my green, my white, and my red, and they're about the same width as well. That's going to make it easier to braid. So I'm going to bring the ends together, and I'm going to slip them into my pipe cleaner. Into my paper clip. And I've moved my other paper clip to this side. So I'm going to slip it in here. Get in there. And I'm going to pull it so that I can get it in the middle. Good. And I'm going to kind of pull it tight. And now, just like we had to separate the red and the yellow and the purple pipe cleaner, I have to separate the red ribbon and the green ribbon and the white ribbon. So my green's going to be on the outside, I can tell that. And now I've got, this is going to be a little harder. Pipe cleaners are so much fun, but I think you boys and girls can do it. So now I've got my two strands of green, my two strands of white in the middle, and my two strands of red on the outside. And I'm holding them pretty tight. All right, here we go again. Now I've got my red on the right, and I'm holding it with my fingers. Oop, let me change the white over here. There's my green on the left, and I'm holding it with my fingers, and I use my middle finger to grab that white strand in the middle. Here I go. I'm going to cross over with my red, and my middle finger here on the left is going to grab that ribbon. I'm going to change my fingers over here so I can hold tight to it. and I'm going to twist the green over the red, and I'm going to grab with my middle finger. There's my middle finger. I'm going to grab it, and I change my fingers on the left, so I'm grabbing tight, and then I twist over, and I'm going to, with my middle finger, I'm going to grab that white ribbon, and I'm going to change my fingers on the green so that I can hold it tight, and then I'm going to twist my red and grab with my middle finger and change my fingers on the left, so I'm holding that white ribbon tight, and then I'm going to keep twisting, boys and girls. I'm going to go a little faster, okay? So I'm going to twist and grab, change my fingers, twist, grab, and change my fingers, twist, grab, and change my fingers, twist, grab, and change my fingers. And now you all know how to braid. That's all I'm gonna do here. So now I've got to tie my end. It's not as easy as it is with pipe cleaners. So I'm gonna grab it, boys and girls. I'm gonna take my two fingers and I'm gonna wrap all my ribbon around my two fingers. So I make kind of a circle with my braid. And what I have to do now is I gotta slip all these ends into this circle. So I gotta come in here, go get it, grab all those ends, pull them through, and then I can bring my braid down over the ends like so. I can pull it tight. And now I've got my real pretty, shiny ribbon braid, and it's ready to go. And my bookmark is ready. Let's go put the other part. We got the little guy that tells me to remember to fix my eyes on Jesus. Let's go. Okay, so we've got our braided pipe cleaners and braided ribbon. So now I've got three. Actually, I have another one waiting for me. But let's just remember how to make our little fella that looks up. So I found this pad of paper and I did a trace because I liked the shape. But if you don't have a shape that you want to draw or a pad of paper like I do, you can just make a square, okay? So I just cut this piece of paper in half and then I'm gonna cut it again. That's just fine. And now I'm gonna draw my little face. And I wanted eyes looking up. So I drew an eye kind of from the middle over and around, and kind of from the middle over and around. And then I did not touching, but I did up like this, and I came up like that. And you guys are probably even better artists than me, but I did that, and then I want him looking up, so I'm making an eyeball here, and an eyeball on his right eye, and then I'm going to give him a pupil, and I'm making it up like that, I'm making it up like that, and then color it in a little bit, I make a little bit of an eyelid, kind of goes like that, and then I kind of made it have a little bit of a wrinkle down below. Hopefully he looks happy to be looking up. And these are my eyes, and you can have an eyebrow like that. Like that. And then I want him to smile. Yeah. And I'm gonna put a couple of eyelashes on it like this. A couple of eyelashes to match there. And you guys can make more eyelashes if you want to. Maybe a few eyelashes down here. Like that. And now I'm going to color him. So I like green. I'm going to go ahead and color like this. And I'm going all the way over him. Oh, you know what I forgot? On this one, I forgot my Bible verse. Let's see if this works with pencil. To go Hebrews, H-E-B-R-E-S. WS, chapter 12, colon, verse 2. And now I'm going to cut it out. And it's ready to go. And it says, Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. And it's ready to go. Oh, there's my first one already in my Bible. And you can see I got all kinds of bookmarks in there, but I like this guy's little happy face. And I can go right to it. Let's see if I can find it. Hebrews, John, Hebrews, James, 1st and 2nd Peter, 1st and 2nd, 3rd. There's Hebrews. Hebrews 12, verse 2. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. This is the last week that we're going to concentrate on the first four of the Ten Commandments. But today, Sunday being Father's Day, I'm going to give you a sneak preview of the fifth commandment. But first, what's the first commandment? Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Number two, thou shalt not make any graven images or idols and worship them. Number three, thou shalt not use the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Number four, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. And that's what you boys and girls are doing today. And a sneak preview for the next commandment, the fifth commandment, being Father's Day. The fifth commandment is, honor thy father and thy mother. Go tell your father or somebody you love dearly the first four or five of the Ten Commandments. They'll be so proud of you. Have a wonderful week, boys and girls.
Kingdoms will
The people who had once demanded Jesus' death were now totally changed by the Holy Spirit. But people didn't change because they had to. It was because they put their faith in Jesus, and it was the Holy Spirit who changed them. It's like if you think about a caterpillar, and then in time the caterpillar totally changes to something different. It changes into a butterfly. Well, that's what happened to the people who heard the good news and who received the Holy Spirit. So when the Holy Spirit came, it was Jesus who sent him. Jesus knew that the disciples needed God's power to share the gospel, especially because they were to tell the good news of Jesus to the whole world. Even though Jesus was in heaven, the Holy Spirit made it possible for the message of salvation to keep spreading.